Good afternoon, I'm James Grunig, or as all of my friends call me, Jim Grunig. I'm a professor emeritus at the University of Maryland. I've been retired for more than 10 years, so I haven't written anything new for a long time, but I'm delighted that you are interested enough in my work to be able to hold this book seminar today to discuss my book, Public Relations in a World of Change. It's a great pleasure to welcome you to this event. It's an honor that my good friends Jungnam Kim, Alessandro Lavari, and Valentina Martino believed enough in my work to translate it into Italian and to explain it to an Italian audience. I'm also grateful to Franca Faccioli for writing the preface for the book. As I noted in the preamble to the book, the three chapters that I wrote for this book summarize my theorizing and research over the approximate 50 years of my career. The question that you're addressing today is whether this work remains relevant in today's world of change and in a global setting outside the United States. My colleague speaking today will discuss this question, and you, my friends in the audience, are also invited to express your ideas about how public relations should be practiced in Italy today and indeed in most of the world. I first wrote the three chapters of this book for a book translated into Portuguese for publication in Brazil. In writing those chapters, I integrated work from a number of my publications so that these chapters provide a broad and comprehensive overview of my work over many years, not just of one or two articles or book chapters that I think are particularly meaningful. I'm grateful to my good friend Maria Paricido Ferrari from Brazil for asking me to write that book, and to the Brazilian publisher Difusão Editora for granting permission to translate these chapters into Italian. As I said in the premise to the book, the first chapter defining and clarifying public relations essentially covers my research and theorizing from the beginning of my career during my PhD program in 1966 to 1968, which for most of you students in this room were not born at that time, but it goes back a long time in my career. And that chapter goes on until the beginning of the study of excellence in public relations and communication management, which many of you have heard about, that began in 1985. Although this first chapter also contains my more recent thinking about that body of work. Much of this chapter is based on my two textbooks, Managing Public Relations and Public Relations, which I wrote with Todd Hunt in the 1980s. In those textbooks, I was able to define public relations, explain its role in organizational management, clarify its professional status, develop a strategic model for practicing different public relations programs and techniques, and think of its broader role in society as an advocate for publics and organizational decisions, as well as an advocate for organizations to publics. A great deal of my research during this time was devoted to developing a situational theory of publics that placed the focus of public relations on the situations and problems of publics, rather than on helping organizations who try to influence or persuade publics to behave as they want them to behave. My colleague Jungnam Kim, who is with you today, has carried on this research tradition and improved it in extremely significant ways, and I'm sure that he will introduce his work to you today. That theory of publics actually began during a two-year period of my life when I lived and worked in the South American country of Colombia, doing research on peasant farmers and large landowners to try to think of communication programs from their perspectives and how publics could serve their interests as well as the organizations themselves. chapter 2 of the book summarizes the major theories and research results from the study of excellence in public relations and communication management that I conducted with 5 colleagues under a grant from the International Association of Business Communicators from 1985 to 2002. That chapter explains the value of public relations function to both organizations and society, and identifies the characteristics of a communication function that increases the likelihood that public relations will provide that value. Most importantly, we found that public relations is most effective when it has 2 key characteristics. It is strategic and symmetrical. That is, when it establishes relationships with the publics that are most affected by organizations, and also the publics that affect the organizations, that is, when it, with strategic publics. And when it does it in a way that helps solve the problems and serve the interests of both society and the publics that make up society, that is the meaning of the word symmetrical public relations. The third chapter summarizes the work that my colleagues, former students, and I did after the completion of the excellence study. In particular, it emphasizes the importance of public relations participating in the strategic management of organizations, that is, a strategic management role for public relations, rather than when it occupies what I call a symbolic interpretive role, where its purpose is mainly to cover up and make the organizations look good or their behaviors look good, even when they're not particularly useful or valuable to publics. So oftentimes that symbolic interpretive role is to create some kind of cognitive representation, such as a positive image, a positive reputation, or impression in such a way that makes the organization look good. Importantly, that chapter explains the importance of relationships and as an outcome of public relations, and adds an ethical framework for both public relations and for organizations. In short, the title of the book emphasizes the 2 major concepts that are important to understanding public relations: publics and relations, or relationships. Public relations helps organizations establish relationships with publics that are affected by the actions of organizations and with whom organizations need relationships in order to serve, be a legitimate participant in society. Is this theory still relevant in today's changing global world? I addressed that question in the interview with Alessandro Lavari and Valentino Martino at the end of the book. As you will see, my answer is yes. I believe that a public relations practice that focuses on the interests of strategic publics, that uses digital media to communicate symmetrically with those publics, and importantly, that uses research on the problems of interest and problems and interest of publics, using what is so-called as big data, is even more relevant today than when I was actively engaged in research myself. I urge you to consider this question today. I may be wrong, but I look forward to hearing your ideas about how public relations should be practiced in Italy, in Europe, and in the rest of the world today. Again, it's a real pleasure to be able to speak with you today. I wish I could be there to hear what you have to say, although I would certainly need an Italian translator. I do speak some Spanish, and it's somewhat similar to Italian, but unfortunately Italian is a little bit more difficult for me to understand. I hope that you find the presentations of my colleagues and friends to be useful and intriguing, and I hope that you find the ideas that I've developed and argued for most of my life are relevant today. Again, have a good seminar, and I hope that you enjoy the day. Thanks very much.